This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about the medians and centroid of a triangle. So let's start with this triangle. I've labeled it ABC, and I'm going to mark the midpoints of each of the sides. Remember, a midpoint is a point that bisects a line segment. So for this triangle, it's cutting each of those sides into two congruent segments. I'll take the midpoint on line on side AB and label that as point D. On side AC, I'll label it as point E. And for side BC, I'll label the midpoint as point F. Now, if I connect a midpoint to the angle opposite to it, I create what's called a median. So I'm going to create a median by connecting points F and A. And I'll do the same thing to create two more medians. I'll connect E and B, and also points D and C. Now the place where those three points intersect, I'll label that as point P, and that's called the centroid of a triangle. There's some interesting things about a centroid. If I do this very accurately, and I draw it on a piece of stiff material, like maybe a piece of cardboard, and I cut the triangle out, then it would balance perfectly on point P. It would balance perfectly on the centroid. The other interesting thing about the centroid is it divides each of those medians in exactly the same way. It divides it so that one segment is half as long as the other segment. In other words, segment FP is half as long as segment PA, and segment EP is half as long as segment PB. Segment DP would be half as long as segment PC. There's a nice, fairly simple proof for this. Here's how it works. We'll start with another triangle. It doesn't matter what shape triangle you draw because this will work for any triangle. So I've labeled the triangle ABC, and I'll mark two midpoints. On side AB, I'll call that midpoint point D, and on side AC, I'll call the midpoint E, and I'll make two medians. I'll connect point E and B, and I'll connect points D and C. So the place where they intersect, the centroid, I'm going to label that as point P. And now I'm going to connect points D and E. Now remember, D and E are midpoints. So if I connect two midpoints, I form a mid-segment. The mid-segment theorem tells me two things about this. It tells me that line DE is parallel to the third side. It's parallel to side BC. It also tells me it's half as long as side BC. Okay, now, I want to show that I have two similar triangles. I want to show the triangle DEP is similar to triangle CBP. Here's how I'm going to do that. I've got two parallel lines, and each of these medians is a transversal that cuts through the parallel lines. So if I've got alternate interior angles along a transversal, they're going to be congruent. So I know that angle PBC is congruent with angle PED. They are alternate interior angles. In the same way, I know that angle PCB is congruent to angle PDE. Well, now I've got these two triangles, and I've got two pairs of congruent angles. Those two pairs of congruent angles tell me that I've got two similar triangles. If I've got two similar triangles, the sides are proportional. The ratios of the sides will be the same. So if side DE is one half as long as side BC, then that means for another pair of corresponding sides, like EP and PB, side EP would be half as long as side PB. And side DP would be half as long as side PC. Now, since point P is the centroid, that's what we were trying to show, that the centroid cut these medians in a 1-to-2 ratio. Okay, so there's your proof for it. Take care. I'll see you next time.